So once we did our calculation, we pick C, 85.75, because we take only this ad valorem. Notice that because this is NAFTA, merchandise processing fee is not applicable, right? The regular fees are not applicable. Only the anti-dumping duty, 7.43%, is applicable in this case. So that's the context of the free trade agreement. Interest rates. All right, so the thing about interest rates, we know that the interest rate, the deposit, you have to deposit your duties at the time the entry summary is filed. The entry summary is filed, the CBP form 75501 is filed when within 10 days after the entry, after you file, we're talking about working days, form 3461, or if you file a live entry, you just deposit that live entry at the time with estimated duties attached, right? How do we know that? Well, we have a law on the books. Let's take a look at that law. So I'll close up this ruling. Let's go to the Code of Federal Regulations. So what is it? It's 142. You guys should know this by now. 142, when entry summary time for filing, 142.12. There. Entry summary documentation shall be, must be filed with estimated duty attached within 10 working days after the time of entry. So 10 working days is the rule, right? All right, so if you deposit estimated duties and those estimated duties found at the later time as a result of the reviews, as a result of the final order determination, are much more, then what you do is you owe more money, obviously, or less money. And if you haven't made that deposit, then you are asked, you provided the supplemental bill, and that bill will include interest rates too, because the money has interest rates, and those interest rates vary. And depending if you're a corporate entity or non-corporate entity, they may vary for you as well based on that. And they are published, I believe, every quarter by customs. So at the time of filing, that's when it starts to kick in, right? So estimate, if you have cash, you have to post cash, right? So interest for underpayments, overpayment will accrue from the date the cash deposit is required, from the date you have to pay that you have to deposit those estimated duties or file entry summary, through the date of liquidation of the entry, or when the customs or the commerce issues liquidation instructions in the case of anti-dumping duties. And if you recall, liquidation is defined as the final computation of duties and fees owed to customs. So that's the time window, the time frame you have is 7501 filing through liquidation. That's duties. If you deposited less, then you have to pay interest. But this is the time frame. This is the time frame. So how do customs examiners test your knowledge on this time frame? Well, let's take a look. All right, so the broker presents a formal entry for merchandise, which is subject to the anti-dumping duty case. So probably type 3 entry. Which of the following statements is false? Well, a certificate of A, certificate of non-reimbursement must be filed with CBP prior to liquidation to avoid the presumption of reimbursement. We shall cover that statement is true. The anti-dumping duty rate assessed at liquidation may be different than the original rate required at the time of deposit. Yes, there may be results of review, final determination, so that's possible. So it is not false. When Secretary of Commerce instructs CBP to liquidate the anti-dumping entry subject to a case, interest is calculated on each entry overpayment or underpayment for summers required suspended prior to the dumping order. What's wrong with that? The statement interest calculated on each entry overpayment and underpayment for summaries required suspended prior to the anti-dumping duty order. No, the order itself is the starting point of assessment. Because before order, you cannot make an assessment. So order itself makes, it can be preliminary order, it can be final order, but that order, right, that order says, okay, this is the deposit you must collect, you must suspend liquidation because after we do reviews, that margin may change. There may be new players, there may be litigation. So a lot of factors can be must be factored in. So suspend until we tell you that you can liquidate. And they publish that in the Federal Register. So prior makes the statement a false statement. Of course, if you are, remember that critical circumstances thing we talked about, right? But that critical circumstances still must to come through the form of some kind of order, right? As we saw in that Russian concrete steel roads critical circumstances review, there was an order in place, published in Federal Register, right? Yes, it was preliminary order, but it was still an order. So prior to that order, no, it has to be on or after that order, right? All right. So at the time of the order is issued, right? Okay, good. A bond, so if it's preliminary, well, if it's final order, then the bond is not acceptable. That's true. Once the anti-dumping case has reached order stage, a revocation is necessary. We're talking about the sunset review, is necessary to end the case. So this is a true statement. So C, that prior to the anti-dumping order, makes the statement false, making C a correct answer choice for this particular question. All right, moving on. Entry codes. All right, so entry codes are provided in CBP form 75501 instructions. There are generally four entry codes which deal with anti-dumping. So entry code is a part of CBP form 7501 reporting requirement. Okay, so we have 03, 07, so that's the consumption entries. Then we have warehouse entries 34, 38. So if you see those numbers, entry types, that's anti-dumping or anti-dumping slash countervailing duty. All right, so exam question. Which entry type is used for warehouse withdrawal of 100% Vietnamese synthetic powder. So if you have warehouse, you automatically know that there should be three, because a warehouse withdrawals is generally type 3 entries, right? So you can immediately exclude E. You can immediately exclude E from the inquiry. And you know it's quota visa combination. So you know it's gonna be only those based on the table above. So you can exclude B as well. So A, B, C. Let's do it this way. A, B, C, D, E, right? So 23 is out, because you deal with warehouse. Then 38 are the only options that deal with entry. So B and C is out. So you have only A and D remaining. You know that this is quota visa combination. And you have quota visa and anti-dumping countervailing duty and no quota visa for warehouse draw. If it's quota visa, then it's 38 entry type. And you have quota visa combination here, which means 38, A is the correct answer, D is out, you pick A and you move on. So this is more or less technical question, and you just have to know where to look at it, CBP 75501 instructions. All right, next one. Foreign entry that contains a product subject to anti-dumping duty rate with current cash deposit rate of zero, you must file blank entry and blank. All right, so if you have a zero, right, you still have to file cash deposit rate, right? You still have to file anti-dumping duty because the review or it can be administrative review, can change that anti-dumping duty cash deposit rate from 3%, from 0% to something else. So if the product is subject to the anti-dumping duty as the scope is described, right, even though the deposit rate separate for that separate particular manufacturer or exporter is zero, it's still the product itself is within the scope. So it is subject to anti-dumping duty. So this means that you still have to qualify it as anti-dumping product, and you must describe it as one of those entry types. You cannot describe it as O1 entry type, which is just just this consumption entry, right? This one is not allowed, free and dutiable. All right, so let's take a look. So A, B, C, D, E. So we know it must be one of those. So type 1 will not do. Consumption will not do. So free and dutiable will not do. So E is out, C is out, and B is out, which is based on that type 1. So type 3 are the candidates. So then we have to move on. A and D, right? Let's take a look at A. Do not indicate the case number or deposit rate on CBP Form 71 because it requires no cash payment. No, you have to indicate the case number because otherwise, how can you establish that this is subject to the separate rate? For example, going back to that ADD search engine, how can you establish whatever case number is applicable? This is 000 countrywide rate, but those are the separate combinations. And if it's zero, you still have to assign. Remember that particular that particular that case dealing with the wind turbines from People's Republic. Let's take a look at it again. So case number 552814. All right. So at this point we have only the 51, 54, 58, 54%, right? But there was a litigation, remember we talked about? So let's go with O. And let's take a look at this one. No, that's not it. Okay, over here. So calculated weighted average dumping margin 0%, right? Is hereby excluding merchandise from the following producer chain of antidumping. So those guys, CS Wind Corporation, the CS Wind Vietnam Company Limited, right? Under those particular case numbers, have zero margin rate. So unlike that 58 percenters, right, countrywide percenters, those guys pay 0%. So this means that if you declare this particular 01 or 02, 001, 002, separate entity, it's still type 3 entry, but this is gonna be zero. But you still have to make it zero, you have to assign the case number. This is just part of the deal. This is part of the declaration, right? You have to do that. And the CBP 75501 instructions makes that explicit. So this means that you have to declare ADD case number. There's just no way around it. So this makes A an incorrect answer choice. So we take A out. D is only one remains standing, and it says declare ADD case on the current line with 0% deposit, just like we saw in that message, right? And pay no deposit at the time of filing because it's zero, right? So that's the correct answer choice D. Based on the fact pattern, right? Please keep in mind that even if the ADD is zero, it's still subject to anti-dumping duty order. All right, next. Which entry types may be used for merchandise subject to anti-dumping duty, countervailing duties? So we have the list, right? 03. 07, 34, 38. So folks, this chart over here in the outline, right? I think it's useful to have it handy. Just keep in mind those four are the anti-dumping related entry types. Since all four of them are included, there is more than one correct answer choice, but all of the above fits great because all of them are anti-dumping countervailing duty type entry type. We're making E a correct answer choice over here. So E is right on point.